So, hey guys, Chauzy here. So it's going to be my Wii 2 Yak showcase. First we're going to do the trial quest just to talk about the plan to use him in general. The focus of this video will be combining Yak with Kaido. I'd love to try and combine Yak with Killer 2 and Kaido because that has some really dope synergy, but at this point in time, like, I don't have Killer. And you kind of want Yak to be have a very high super tandem, which will take a while. So yeah, we see the ulti on page 1 here to reduce the CD. Finally, they actually had to add an interrupt to Chainlock here because otherwise page 1 will block Yak. So it's a pretty weird batch, but sure. But yeah, basically when we use Yak once, you see here we apply 30% driven and strike resistance. So that can be stacked, like if you are both Driven Striker, you get both of those. Then when we use Yak again, we get that 60% Striker and Driven Resistance. We also buff the Chain Lock. Then when we use Kaido, we remove the buffs we have, except for the Chain Boundary. We still have the Resistance applied to the enemy. Can use Black Maria here to also get Color Affinity and a Base Attack boost. Then when we use Yak again, we will buff that base attack boost. As you see currently, it's a plus 800 base attack boost. But after using Yak a third time, we will be buffing that by 500 more, so it becomes a plus 1300 base attack. And we also buff the resistance again, minus 90% to Driven and Striker. So a unit like Yak and Kaido here, who have Striker and Driven, will do basically 180% more damage. So that's pretty good. Also use the super class to apply increased damage taken. So yeah, this is basically how you plan to use it. Yak has both super tandem and a super class special, which is nice for Kaido because obviously after using Kaido special, you can only use two more specials, which is also why the synergy with Killer is pretty dope, since Killer can add Death Down Conditional to this as well, while Yak's Super Tandem and Super Claws have potential to give Death Down, so you can add even more damage without having to use specials. But yeah, I made two teams for this video. First, we're doing everybody's favorite Grand Voyage again. It's time for Grand Voyage Luffy. And hey, like, it's the easiest Grand Voyage, but I can't help what unit Bandai releases. Like, it's fun to try out a new unit against Grand Voyage. But yes, so happens we get a lot of int-driven units. Where else do we try them but Luffy? But I managed to make a pretty interesting team, though. It doesn't have any Katakuri or any Ui to Blackbeard. This means that we have to stall a turn final stage, which means we do get some very annoying debuffs, like the Luffy final stage will apply resilience to himself. The Luffy will also put up a 3-turn barrier. He will add blindness, like as you hear, it's pretty annoying. But it actually works out as long as you can add enough damage. And due to Kaido, we can use Yak special on two different stages. And that helps a lot because Yak special is actually very good both on this stage and on the final stage. Like on this stage, we get the chain boundary, which lets us bypass the chain attack down. We also remove the rainbow shield. That's why I run this old trash map recruit Big Mom, because she can handle damage threshold. And we just ignore the death up because we do more than enough damage with the chain boundary and the Uta support, as well as some or nice or money from this old one cost Zoro. So yeah, first time I've used this Big Mom since her treasure map. It's nice to see her get some use. The main use for this Big Mom is that she is low cost, and as a bonus she also has the Sweet Commander support. We can remove the special bind final stage. This lets us use Yak special first turn final stage. We can block the chain lock, which Luffy also applies if you stop. So yeah, I'm just trying to consume as many Wano and Tandem Orbs as possible, so we can make use of Kaido's versus special final stage. So yeah, as said, sweet commander support. We also have Perona, just to make perfects even easier. We'll help with the blindness we're going to get. But yeah, we use Yak, and I can't get over this, like, we really didn't need a V2 Yak, and did we? If we were to get a V2 Yak, did we really need, like, one of the worst designs in One Piece history? Like, I don't know that, but sure. At least it's a pretty interesting unit, and in the end, that's what interests me the most. But I will prefer, like, basically another unit than Yak to get another legend. Anyway, we use Kid here, so this is the final special we can use. We get some orbs, we get a big attack boost and a orb boost from Law Support. Yak will set defense to 0 here. And Kaido will do the end of turn damage, and we also get some increased damage taken. So the strat when you use this kind of team is always that you try and hit twice on Luffy, start breaking the barrier, then you move on to Zoro and Nami, and then you have two more hits on Luffy, and yeah. Didn't have to try that much this time, I got them practice on this strat, so to say. But yeah, that's Kaido and Jack against level 5 Grand Rearch. Next, we're going to try an arena, we're going to see, try and see a bit, like, what is the idea to try and get maximum damage with this combination. We won't really get that in this team, like, there are two issues. First, I need to find a level 4 or above Super Tenon Jack, which actually isn't impossible. I have one friend who has a Rainbow Jack. He got really lucky, he pulled like 5 Jack in 7 multis, absolutely insane. But I didn't want to spam him, and I also noticed that the main problem is that I just do too much damage, like, with Yak, you can get, with Yak's high super tandem, you can get a guaranteed death down through full immunity. But even without the death down applied, I almost killed hitting goods. So yeah, I felt like, let's just show how it works in practice. But yeah, Arena Sasaki here. First time I use him, basically. I use him twice to remove attack down. And we also need 3 Beast Pirates for the Super Tandem. Very easy kill. And the Annie ship makes showcasing stuff a lot more chill. Don't even need to stall. Everything is ready. But yeah, we're going to use the combination of Vivi and Robin here. Might look weird that we're using these units, but the main thing I want to showcase is different ways you can add damage when using versus Kaido. Since he limits you to 2 specials, but there are other ways to get more damage without using special. But yeah, Robin is the only fully unboosted unit on this team. But yeah, moving on to final stage, going to stall a turn first. Then I will be using Yak. Yak applies a chain boundary and resistance. And then we can use Kaido, and Kaido can't delete Chain Boundary or Resistance, so we keep those. Very nice. Then we can use Yak again, apply even more resistance to the enemy, buff the Chain Boundary, and then we can use Blackbeard, or that's wrong, we use Blackbeard first because Blackbeard gives a base attack boost and death down, and then Yak can buff the base attack boost from Blackbeard as well. Kaido also has the Orochi support, which is really nice because then he can do attack boost, orb boost, Call of Infinity boost. Really dope combo. That support alone probably makes Orochi one of the most valuable PvP legends, to be honest. But if we do get a death down conditional, and if we had Yak's fully maxed super tandem, we will have got a death down through full immunity, which is really cool. But as said, not using it here, and if I did use it, I will kill before activating the Super Tandem anyway, so it's fine. This is more like a proof of concept kind of thing. How will you use it in reality? And yeah, Super Claws just to get the Super Driven. I actually forgot to swap Fever back, which is so dumb. Main reason I used them was to show you that you can swap to get buffs as well. But anyway, that's the video. See ya. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.